boys and girls, this is going to be the episode of the speed carburetor. I use this intake first to give it the only chance it'll ever have of not leaking air, because the speed carburetor is notorious for leaking air. And I don't really like the carburetor. The wherever the primer, I took that out and I tapped it quarter 28 and put a set screw in it to just block it off, because it kept coming off and it kept leaking. So the video you're going to see, I'm going to make a couple runs. I'm going to run it with this first, and then I'm going to run it with the stock exhaust, not the polished one, but the one that came on the motor itself. And it was an interesting result. Predictable, as far as I'm concerned, but definitely interesting, as you're going to see. So, but there's a few things I want to show you. You're going to see me using this. Here's a link for this. I took one of these old ones. One of the old ones I had. Cut it off. And basically bolted it onto here with a piece of plastic on the inside. Okay, came in handy on this trip because my GPS fell off again. I bought this. Here's a link for this too, by the way. I had a bunch of 18650 batteries laying around, and I bought this power bank. It wasn't very much. So basically what I can do, this thing has a passage for headphones or whatever, and then I can keep my battery charged. I like this opposed to these, because these are a pain in the ass to get on. If you ever used one, then they get all twisted up. These, on the other hand, are a lot easier to put on. You just go right over your head. Snap, snap. So it's a lot easier, a lot more comfortable. Not only that, you got storage for your wallet, keys, cell phone. Let's don't forget that cell phone. And because trust me, it'll bite you in the ass if you do. And you got a zipper spot here, and I guess a gun, knife, clips, ammo, whatever. Alright? So we've had a little fire down here this week. Let me show y'all some pictures of it right now. And yeah, that's right there where I ride, right there by, right on the levee. And I'm glad I wasn't able to ride that far. I hate to see that, but this one picture right here is a picture I took out of my front door. It actually blocked the sun out. Couldn't see it. I mean, you couldn't see the sun. So, guys, hit like and subscribe, please. Enjoy the video. This is with the speed carburetor. Next, we are going to put the NT back on it with the stock intake, and then we're going to start running expansion chambers and see what they do. I don't need to run the NT anymore because it did 37. None of them ever come close. And so, fortunately. But maybe the other ones will shine all better with an expansion chamber. But we're going to try the NT first. I'm running the same jet in all of them. The reason I'm doing that is because when you normally buy one of these carburetors, you're going to get a 70 jet in. People say, oh, yeah, I get them to run good and all that. I don't have time to jet them. They're all going to run 70 jets, like it or not. And the reason for that is when you buy one, you're not going to be, you know, this is for guy that's going to buy one carburetor is not going to have all these jets. Now, it's kind of like a chia pet. This hobby is, once you water it, it starts sprouting everywhere. So, yes, we got plenty of parts and stuff. I have been doing some major work, or I've had some major work done on my crane rail up there. I'm afraid it was going to fall. Did a lot of welding up there and what have you. I got a remote control for this, which is a wiring nightmare, literally. I actually had to order two relays because this thing is like to activate relays or what have you. It's not really there, but this is very safe. I've got this one that works all this up here and that over there. If I'm picking up on something or holding something up, which I'll be able to now, then this won't get interfered. And I don't want to hit a button on one and then all of a sudden everything takes off. So that's the reason for that. So, but that's going to be really cool. I got the relays coming in yet. So like I said, y'all enjoy the video. It is what it is. You speed carburetor guys, you like them and what have you. To me, I've had nothing but air leaks with them. You got a cram them full of ultra gray or some kind of goop just to seal them off because they're cut so much on the side. And that's been my experience with it. Anyway. So, but it didn't leak with this one, but they don't because of the O-ring. So, thank you so much for watching. Please hit like or subscribe. Y'all have a wonderful day. Enjoy the video.
All right, let's give this speed carburetor a chance. It's hot. I don't even have to heat it up, warm it up. It's already hot. It's already 100 degrees. Actually, what does it say? I can't even see it. It's showing air. I don't know why. We know it runs about 235, something like that. Tight, the choke is nice and tight. Gas is on. Hang on. I guess I got my helmet on. You'll see me better there? Good. I don't know why that's good. Thank you. good. Idle's good. Good on the low. Just died. And the damn choke done slipped down again. Get out of here. Was that it? I wonder. Let me get out the damn road. One of these dumb son of bitches run over me. Well, that wasn't impressive, but that's with the short intake and the open exhaust, which we noted that it didn't do good with the HP, so let's swap it over to a regular intake and a regular muffler. Turning all the lights off. We're probably going to have an intake leak, an air leak. I'll be surprised if we don't. And hopefully the choke doesn't drop down on us. All right, we're gonna put the choke down to start off with. Thank you. Here we go. We can see it's got max speed. .32. That's a damn shame. The speed couldn't even outbeat the HD. Who would have thought, huh? Oh well. I don't have to go any farther with this. The NT is the carb we're going to use. On the stock intake.